I'm Yuri. Welcome to the last talk before lunch, the most important thing. I know everyone's tired, so I'll try to be as quick as possible. I do maps. I like maps. I do a lot of disruptive, mostly socially, but try to do technologically disruptive too, things such as Map Libre and other little fun, interesting projects. Martin, if anyone has heard of that, I've been working on that. Wikipedia maps, graphs, a lot of stuff. Anyway, the important thing I want to bring today is I have been hacking on what's called vector tiles. Who has not heard of vector tiles here? Nice. Okay, good. Good. I love it. Okay, my job is done here. So MVTs are very cool. They are used pretty much everywhere in the stack nowadays, and we love them, or we like to hate them, or whatever. They do good things for what they were designed to do, which was visualization in 2D space. They have very wide support in all the tool chains. Like, you can use it. You can generate it from Postgres directly. You can generate from Elasticsearch, of which I used to be a part of, so I still wear a shirt. I really like them. I'm a Trivian now, by the way, this disclaimer. You can ship the tiles into standard packaging formats. They're all supported there as well. You can use Map Libre for visualizing them, as well as some other stacks like Open Layers also supported. It's a great project. But the problem is they're pretty slow. They're only focused on 2D. They're really hard to use for anything that goes outside of the scope of the original design. And well, they don't support any of the data types, which goes for the scope thing. So that's what my goal is. So I created this little GitHub repo. It's called NUric Future MVT, self-explanatory. So far, 51 replies, 14 comments, 12 participants. Some of them are very well known in this tiny little mapsy space of ours. And the idea is to expand MVTs to something better and grander, to cover data for cars. As I said, I work for Rivian. And we want to use them for other things. At least I want Rivian to use them for other things, and such as, for example, driving data, data about lanes and about elevation ahead of you, so that self-driving cars can think ahead or something. Metadata for curvature, for example. If you have a geometry, you want to know how that curvature changes along the lines. I mean, technically you could calculate it, but in some cases it's real hard, so it's better to do it server side. Or just simple arrays of values that are also not supported in an MVT. I've spoken with about Valhalla people. They also want to use it in some way, but they have their very different use case. They have tiles for routing. I mean, there is a geometry or a GIS component to them in the sense that every piece of data they have is geolocated somewhere, but otherwise it's a very different data format. But it would be wonderful to use the same tooling, the same Postgres and Elasticsearch and others, to generate that data, process it, and this way, well, how a project all of a sudden will be cut down by a third. Third of their code is focused on tile management. They shouldn't be doing this. I mean, that's why they're running out of people and resources to manage it, because they have to spend all this energy on other things. And it's a wonderful, wonderful project, but it would be wonderful to be able to collaborate with them. 3D, I mean, who doesn't like 3D? We all want 3D buildings and other fun things to be shown. So that's that. And well, performance, everyone's love, a favorite child. Like, oh, we want faster tile loading. Well, guess what? Protobufs with delta compressions and other things does not really work well. So I'm proposing like all these things to be worked together as a community, as industry members, can improve data generation for Postgres. Now there's all these tooling available for that. We can do tooling for CLI data generation, data serving. As I said, Map Libre is hosting Martin. Martin is a tile server that can dynamically generate this data and create it in different formats. And we can do it visualization too, so that all the traditional tools like Map Libre can support it directly. Thank you very much. Please ask questions away if you have any.